Immersed has finally released onto the Vision Pro App Store, bringing a whole new way of using your computer on the high-resolution, great pass-through headset. If you don't already know, Immersed is a remote desktop productivity app that first came onto the Meta Quest and lets you have up to 5 virtual monitors surround you, which makes it a godsend for productivity as you can imagine. It got released in a sort of beta form for the Vision Pro a month ago, and I made an entire video about it highlighting the good and bad that I found in it. Now that it's officially released, I thought it'd be cool to show it off for the people who haven't seen it yet, see what updates the Immersed team has made, and if any of my complaints were addressed. So, if you didn't see my last video, this is Immersed on the Vision Pro. I've got 5 completely virtual screens of my Windows desktop, and I can change the resolution to whatever I want. A little overkill? Maybe, but it all works, and with pretty good latency too. If you're wondering about how it works with games, I played it with only the best titles, like, Kimono Front Ceiling May Cry, the only game on Steam with an overwhelmingly positive rating. Don't look it up, just look at this amazing gameplay and you'll know it's true. The game runs... yeah, it just kind of runs. In the footage itself, you can notice the micro stutter is present, which make it a not great experience overall. If I go into an alternative remote desktop app like Moonlight, you can see it's a lot smoother than on Immersed. I tried the same with a 2D game like Undertale, and yeah, I'm definitely gonna blame my loss here on Immersed, not because I suck or anything. And then, here's some Honkai Star Rail footage, definitely noticeable here too. I'm pretty sure your mileage may vary though, and network stuff is always a pain, so who knows. One thing that I love that's improved since the beta release is the polished UI. The menu bar works now and shows you the session time, time, and battery percentage, which is more useful than you think. There's also a bigger bar under the monitors now to make it easier to change the curvature and position of them. However, the biggest gripe I have with Immersed currently is the new system that they have for moving monitors around. Moving a monitor even just a little bit makes it all huge and rotated, which just messes with my entire setup. I'm not sure if this is a feature or not with how poorly the system works, but I will say that in my experience, Immersed has always had a finicky monitor movement system even on the Quest, so who knows. If you've come from Quest Immersed, a lot of features are missing like environments, friends, and even signing into your personal account. However, one feature that they did bring over is phone screen sharing, allowing you to see your phone in VR. The latency on this is really low and can be very useful for notifications and stuff. Alright, I want to make life hard for editor me, so let's quickfire through some more thoughts. Foveated rendering is still a big issue, crashing is not as often, but still happens. There's no input method so you can't connect your keyboard to the Vision Pro, but all in all it works well. Aside from my issues with it, it's a great way to use more than one monitor on the Vision Pro, and the support for all major operating systems like Linux, Windows, and Mac, and its low latency makes it my favorite way overall. Immersed on all of its platforms is free, but the $5 subscription unlocks all of the monitors and higher resolutions. I don't really have a need for the extra monitors or 4K resolution when using Immersed, so it's not worth it for me, but maybe it is for you. Make sure to like and subscribe for more ramblings about large rectangles surrounding your vision just like this one. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and take care.